Good morning, students. Welcome to Sri Sai Vignan Bharati Junior College. I am Manohar. I teach Mathematics 1B. So here the college has an excellent faculty. Mostly Maths, Physics, Chemistry. So the Maths lecturer, I am the Maths lecturer Manohar. The most experienced faculty, Surendranath Tagore, is a very experienced faculty. And next is Charan Singh. He teaches chemistry in our college. He is also very, very experienced. And if it comes to MEC, we have one more maths faculty, Mr. Mohan. And he teaches 1A for the students, for MEC and MPC also. And economics, lecturers are there, madams are there. And commerce, the most experienced faculty, Mr. Anand, teaches very well. He also have a good rapport with the students. He brings admissions to our college. And when it comes to the subject, mathematics, we have 1A and 1B. So in 1A, the main topic what we have in 1A is trigonometry. Trigonometry already you have in 10th class. Okay, so very easy in intermediate also, it's nothing to worry. Our lecturers will support all the students. No need to worry about the subject. Trigonometry, mathematical induction, matrices, these are the main topics you have in intermediate mathematics 1A. I am talking about 1A. So in this 1A, trigonometry, you need just basics. Okay, so it's a very easy topic. 1A lecturer will support you, no need to worry about 1A. And coming to 1B, 1B you have coordinate geometry, the topic which you have in 10th class, coordinate geometry. Here you have a subject on based on that. So coordinate geometry, if you have a basics, it's very good. Or else the lecturers also will support you, no need to worry about 1B and 1A mathematics. So you have joined a very good college, your choice is excellent. So all the faculty lecturers will support you, including the principal Rama madam. Everyone will support you. So as a subject wise, the lecturers of maths, physics, chemistry, economics, commerce, all the lecturers will support you in all the ways. Any doubts, any clarifications, nothing to worry. We all clarify, all the lecturers are with the students. No need to worry. And as this COVID-19 is there, so it's not possible to run the classes regularly. Offline classes, it's not possible. So we teach online classes and no need to worry. On online classes also, we give a very clear-cut explanation. Nothing to worry about that. So the lecturers, all the lecturers will support you in all the forms. Okay? So coming to the topics in 1A, see, in 1A we have, this is a 1A, mathematics we have 1A and 1B. So topics in 1A, what we have is, we have functions, mathematical induction, matrices and determinants, vector algebra and trigonometry. So these are the topics you have in 1A. So already you are familiar with trigonometry. So that just extension you have in the trigonometry. If you have basics in trigonometry, no doubt it is very easy. Suppose if you feel it was a difficult topic and you didn't refer well in 10th minutes, no need to worry. Our lecturers are going to take care from the basic of the trigonometry. So when class starts, our lecturer, 1A lecturer, will start the topic from the basic level and will support. No need to worry about this chapter. And the remaining matrices and determinants is also very easy topic. It's easy for all. The weightage of this chapter is 24 marks. So it is out of, see, the 1A is about 75 marks paper. 1A is a 75 marks paper, 1B is 75 marks paper. So out of that 75, the matrices and determinant is 24 marks. So this is a very easy topic. And one more thing is that due to this COVID, intermediate board is decreasing the syllabus. It's just reducing the syllabus. maybe some topics they remove which are tough. We don't know, we didn't get any notification about those topics. But after getting the topics, after getting the notification, some topics will be reduced. Till that time, we teach all the topics, no need to worry. So these are the topics we have in 1A, trigonometry. Matrices and determinants is easy, very very easy, 24 marks. And mathematical induction is 7 marks topic. One essay question you will get in this chapter. So this is also an easy topic, no need to worry about that. And in one word, what I tell is nothing to worry about maths, physics, chemistry or economics, commerce. Our lecturers are going to take care. We have an excellent faculty in all these subjects. So you have chosen a very best college. You get all types of support which the student needs. Okay, so these are the topics in 1A. Okay, so now we'll see the topics in 1B. So now we'll see the topics in 1B. So topics in 1B are locus, change of axis, straight lines, pair of straight lines. See, these topics is just based on the coordinate geometry which you have in 10th class. So coordinate geometry means distance between two points, midpoint, section formula. Okay, so based on these concepts, this concept we have all these chapters. Locus, change of axis, straight lines and pair of straight lines. Okay, then we have three dimensional coordinates. It's a new topic. It's a new topic for all the intermediate students who are in first year. Three dimensional coordinates, direction ratios and direction cosines, differentiation and applications of differentiation. So all these topics are new for all the intermediate students. Okay, even in 1A, also the vector algebra, and then you have mathematical induction, functions are new to all the students. So no need to worry about those topics. Our lecturers will take care of all those things. And so these are the topics in 1A. And these are the just based on this coordinate geometry. So again, this 1B paper, weightage of this top 1B is 75. 75 marks 1A, 75 marks 1B. So these are the topics you have in 1B. So now, coming to the topic, so first I'll start 1B. So 1B based on the coordinate geometry. Now today just it's an introduction class. So just we discuss the formulas which you learned in 10th class. Okay, so in 10th class coordinate geometry, we have some important formulas which is helpful for intermediate. So the first is distance between two points. Distance between two points. Okay, so distance between two points. So in a coordinate system, if the point A is x1, y1 and B is x2, y2, if these are the two points, the distance between two points is AB is equal to under root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay, this is the distance between two points in a coordinate system. The points are x1, y1, x2, y2. Okay, this is a formula. And after this distance between two points, we have a section formula. So, what is a section formula? The section formula is nothing but, suppose you have a line joining two points A and B. Okay, you have a line joining two points A and B. The coordinates of A is x1, y1 and coordinates of B is x2, y2. A is x1, y1, B is x2, y2. And a point, some point, I am assuming that point as P, is dividing the line joining points in the ratio m1 is to m2. The ratio m1 is to m2. So to find the coordinates of this point P, we use a section formula. So what is that section formula? That is nothing but m1 x2 plus m2 x1 y, m1 plus m2, m1 x2 plus m2 x1 by m1 x2, m1 plus m2 comma, m1 y2 plus m2 y1, m2 y1 by m1 plus m2. So this is a section formula Using the section formula, we have a different problems in 10th class. We can find out the point which is dividing the ratio M1 is to M2. Suppose if a point is given to you, then you can also find the ratio M1 and M2. M1 and M2. We have these type of problems in 10th class. So this also is very important for our intermediate first year 1B. And the section formula, then after that we have a midpoint. So midpoint. Okay. So midpoint. Now here in midpoint, two line joining points are there, A and B. A is x1 by 1 and B is x2 by 1. These are the two line joining points. And now we have to go. We have to find out a point C. Just mark it as C. That C will be dividing a line in the same ratio. It is in the same ratio. 1 is to 1 or 2 is to 2 or M is to M, something. So to find the coordinates of that midpoint, the formula is x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay. So this is a midpoint formula we use to find out this point C. Then after the midpoint, we have area of triangle. The next one is area of triangle. So area of triangle, when the three coordinates are given. Now suppose this is triangle A, B, C. A is x1, y1. B is x2, y2. And C is what? x3, y2. If these are the three coordinates in a plane, that the coordinates belong to a triangle, then how we find the area of triangle? It is delta is equal to half mod C. One easy way to remember the formula, the easy way is, first you write x into y minus y plus x into y minus y plus x into y minus y. Okay, you write this x into y minus y, three times you write. Now, we take the points in cyclic order. That means just put 1, 2, 3. We follow the cyclic order to write the formula. We follow the cyclic order. What is cyclic order? After writing x into y minus y for 3 times, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 you write. 1, 2, 3. First we started with 1. Now start with 2 and maintain the same order. 2, 3, 1. 2, 3, 1. Then, now you start with 3, it will be 3, 1, 2. That is the cyclic order we are taking. 3, 1, 2. Okay. So this is a formula. This is the area of triangle formula. We find out when three vertices of a triangle is given. So what is the formula? Delta is equal to half mod x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Okay. This is the area of triangle formula. And one more thing is, if the points are collinear. So collinear means what? What are collinear points? So collinear points means if all the three points lie on a same line, then we say the points are collinear. If all the three points lie on the same line, then we say the points are collinear. So if the points are collinear, what is the condition? The area of triangle is zero. That means this delta is equal to half mod whatever we have, this is to be equated to zero. You have problems in 10th class. So you know how to prove the points are collinear, just find out the area of triangle, the result should be zero. So here if the points are collinear, the area of triangle is zero. That is one condition you have in 10th class. And one more condition I am going to tell is, if the points are collinear, slope of AB is equal to slope of BC. See, if the points are collinear, all the points lie on the same line. To prove that the points are collinear, we find out slope of AB. Next we find out slope of BC. both the slopes should be equal, then only the points are collinear. Now, how to find the slope when two points are given? How to find the slope when two points are given? See, now A is equal to x1 comma y1, B is equal to x2 comma y2 are two points. Then how will you find the slope? Slope of AB is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this is a formula slope you have in 10th class. So again we just recollect this, slope of AB is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So these are the basic formulas you have in 10th class. All are helpful for intermediate first year. See, now I'll just give an introduction in 1A. So coming to this 1A, first topic is trigonometry, which you have in 10th class. So that is the reason I am just discussing about the trigonometry. See, in trigonometry we have different types of trigonometric ratios. So what are those trigonometric ratios? Sine. Actually SINE is sine, but we write it as SINE, it is sine. And next we have cosine, but we write it as cos. Then tangent, but we write it as, or we call it as tan. Sine, cos, tan, and cotangent is called, we call it as cot. Sine, cos, tan, cot, secant, and then we have cosecant. Okay, so these are the different trigonometric ratios we have, and just some tips are there to remember these formulas. Okay, so just we discuss those now. So now sine is related to cosecant. Cos is related to secant. Tan is related to cot. See what you do, just remember this order. Sine, cos, tan, cot, secant, cosecant. Don't change this order. Okay. Just remember this order. And yes, sine is related to cosecant. Just you can draw these lines. You get one lines like this. So now, what is the relation between them? Now sine. Sine is related to cosecant. Relation is nothing but here sine and cosecant. Sine is 1 by cosecant. Sine is 1 by cosecant. Sine is related to cosecant. Means sine is a reciprocal of cosecant, you can say. Or what is cosecant? Cosecant is 1 by sine. Okay, it's a reciprocal again. Then cos. Cos is related to secant. To secant, or secant is 1 by cos. Secant is 1 by cos. Okay, then after that, tan, reciprocal of cot, or cot will be 1 by tan. Okay, so from this you can remember these formulas. Sine is related to secant, cos is related to secant, tan is related to cot. So you can remember very easily by writing this. You can, by seeing this, you can write the formula. This is one of the easy way to remember this formula. Now next is trigonometric value theorem. It's very important for 1A, 1B also. So how to remember this value table as well now? See, first what we do is, first we remember, first to fill this table, first how to fill the table as well. First to write this table, what are the first four whole numbers we have? The first four whole numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are the first four whole numbers. Okay. So now after writing the first four whole numbers, all these numbers you divide by 4. By 4, by 4, by 4, by 4, by 4. All these numbers divide by 4. First we are writing the first four whole numbers. Each and every number you divide by 4. Then after that you apply square root for all these numbers. Square root for all these numbers. After applying the square root, see, 0 by anything is 0. So put 0. Okay. Then square root of 1 is 1. Square root of 4 is 2. So write 1.2. Then you can cancel this. 2 1s are 2 2s are. Okay, 2 1s are 2 2s are cancels. So square root of 1 is 1. Square root of 1 is 1 by root 2. Okay, then the next one. If I split the root, I get root 3 by square root of 4 is 2. 4 by 4 is 1. Square root of 1 is 1. So in this way we get the first row of sine. So what is sine we get? 0, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2, 1. So first we will understand. See how you got I told, but you can by heart, this is no problem. The first row you please remember. Now how to get cos? Just reverse the sign. That means 1 root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2, 0. Reverse the sign. Then after that, how to get tan? See, tan is a reciprocal of cot. No, tan is equal to 1 by cot. But we don't know cot. So what is tan? Tan is nothing but sine by cos. Tan is nothing but sine by cos. So tan is sine by cos. So now to write the tan, we just divide this. See, 0 by 1. What is 0 by 1? 0 by 1 is 0. So write 0. So here 1 by 2 by root 3 by 2. 1 by 2 by root 3 by 2. 2 cancel. So we get 1 by root 3. So write here 1 by root 3. Okay, then next, when we divide these two, root 2, root 2 cancel. 1 by 1 is nothing but 1. So tan 45 is 1. Next, tan 16. So you can cancel 2 and 2. Root 3 by 1 is root 3. Next, we have 1 by 0. Now what is something by 0? Something by 0 is not defined, or not defined can also be written as a symbol called infinity. So here not defined means you can use infinity or just write not defined, no problem. So after getting tan, you got tan sine by cos. Now how to get cot? Just reverse the tan or reciprocal of tan. Now just reverse this. So what we get? Infinity root 3 1 1 by root 3, 0. So just reverse this, we get cot. After cot, we have secant. Now what is secant? Secant is reciprocal of cos. So reciprocal of cos means what? 1 by 1. Just reciprocal of 1 is 1. See, reciprocal of root 3 by 2 is 2 by root 3. Take the reciprocal. And reciprocal of 1 by root 2 is root 2. 1 by root 2 is root 2. Reciprocal of 1 by 2 is 2. Reciprocal of 0. Here you have 0. So 0 means it is 0 by 1. What is reciprocal of this? It will become 1 by 0. So something by 0 again is not defined, or just write infinity. Now how to get cosecant? Cosecant is nothing but reverse of secant. Cosecant is nothing but reverse of secant or reciprocal of sine. Anything you can do. So just what we do, just I do the reverse of the secant. So it is infinity 2 root 2 2 by root 3 and 1. Okay, so this is a trigonometric table. Just you refer this. Okay, so again we will have one more class. Next class also we will discuss this trigonometry. Please refer this. Okay, thank you.